2017 graduation ceremony. Seniors, congratulations. Parents, congratulations. I'd like to thank the parents and the teachers, staff, administrators for helping us get these seniors where they're at today. It's quite an accomplishment. To begin this ceremony, I'd like to introduce the distinguished guests that are on the stage. The Knox County R1 School Board, President Mr. Kelly Hayes, Vice President Mr. Matt Reel, Treasurer Mr. Mark Cardwell, Secretary Mrs. Shelley View, Member Mrs. Karen Hall, Member Mr. Justin Parrish, Member Mr. Nathan Shingle. Also on the stage, we have our high school principal, Mr. Brian Brown. Our featured speaker this afternoon is one of our own. She obtained her teaching degree from Truman State University and has been our middle school science teacher for the last 24 years. She is married to Randy Carlson, and together they have four children, Jared, Michael, Matthew, and Emily. It is my honor to present our featured speaker, Mrs. Kelly Carlson.
Thank you, Mr. Turgeon. Hello, graduates and guests. Today is a great day to be an Eagle. Today is also a great day because the Lord has made it. He planned for you to be at this particular place and time in your lives. And because He did so, please join me in a prayer to thank the Lord for this day. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for our graduates. We pray you give them direction, purpose, and perseverance as they enter the next phase of their lives. Bless them and give them courage to achieve their dreams. We know each one gathered today holds a special place in the hearts of our graduates. We thank you for our moms and dads, family, teachers and administrators, staff and board members, coaches, pastors and friends, people who through the years have cheered on our graduates, prayed for them, and supported them every step of the way. Father God, I invite you to join us this afternoon. Fill this place with your presence. I pray my words will honor and glorify you. May all of these things be done in the name of Jesus, our precious Lord and Savior. Amen. Amen. Thank you for the honor and privilege of being our guest graduation speaker, especially since I haven't been your teacher since middle school. As a matter of fact, probably the last time I gave you a lesson was at grade 3 promotion. And during that speech, I gave you a little quiz. But don't worry, I'm not going to do that today. You've already been tested, your academic skills are completed, assessments in non-study schools. But since I was once your science teacher, I can't resist in giving you a final science lesson before you graduate. Our science lesson today is about light. First, let's review the concept of light. A science textbook usually defines light as a part of the electromagnetic spectrum between infrared radiation and ultraviolet rays called visible light. Each of us has stumbled around in the darkness and can appreciate the power of good light. Do you remember your fifth grade middle school trips to the caves in Hannibal? In the camera cave, we carried lanterns or flashlights to guide us through the cave. And when the lights were turned off, we could see absolutely nothing. We couldn't see the walls of the cave or even our friends standing right beside us. Without this visible light, we were in complete and utter darkness. Even God recognizes the importance and need for light. In Genesis 1:3, God said, "Let there be." Very good. God saw the light was good, and He separated the light from the darkness. By His very command, God gave us light by creating the sun, the moon, and the stars. Now, graduates, you're old enough to understand there are different types of light and darkness. As your science teacher, you may recall I like to tell stories to teach my lessons. As you listen, search for the light and darkness in my story. Today, my story begins with a person much like you. This highly motivated young man attended school and decided to further educate himself by becoming a lawyer. In fact, his debating skills were exemplary. And just like your future holds great promise, it was thought he held great promise in becoming a member of the Supreme Court. However, this young man named Saul had another side. He hated people who were different from him, who didn't agree with his way of thinking. As a matter of fact, his early life was marked by brutal violence and relentless persecution of the early church. In his religious zeal, he entered house after house, dragging off men and women, throwing them in prison, or stoning them to death because their beliefs were different from his own. By now, you figured out the darkness in the stories, not the physical darkness he experienced in the caves, but his wicked behavior of sin. Wicked behavior can take on many forms: cruel words, lying, cheating, stealing, and in Saul's case, violence and hatred. As our story continues, Saul and his friends went on a journey with the intent to terrorize more people. But God had a different plan for this young man, and while he was on his journey, God blinded him using a brilliant light. Saul was plunged into the very darkness he had sought to spread, and just like your experience in the cage, he could not see the hand in front of his face. Now I ask you, what was the light in the story? Well, the light in the story seems to be the same light you experienced using flashlights in the cave. In fact, it's quite different. You see, this light wasn't the light that helps you see with your eyes. This was the type of light that helps you see with your heart. This was the type of light that breaks through darkness of sin, the darkness that causes spiritual and emotional pain and suffering. This type of light brings kindness, joy, patience, peace, and love. This type of light is life-altering. In fact, Saul's transformation was so great his name was changed to Paul. Paul no longer hated others who were different from him. He used his passion to help the very people he once terrorized. Paul even wrote about this powerful light. In Ephesians 5:8-9, Paul writes, "For you were once darkness." Notice he doesn't say you were in darkness, you were the darkness. "But now you are light in the Lord. Live as children of light. The fruit of life consists of goodness, righteousness, and truth." Paul became one of the greatest lights in the world, sharing God's love and message of hope and grace to all people. Now, would you leave your science teacher if I didn't require you to perform one final science activity using the information in the lesson? As with most science activities, you must first have a question to answer or a problem to solve. And your problem today will be to design a model that answers the question, how will you be a light? A brilliant light that breaks through darkness, chasing away the shadows you will encounter in life. The type of light Paul described, a person who's good, kind, brings peace, truth, and joy to those around you. Now we're ready for our science procedure. Everyone in the gym is going to participate at some point. So listen carefully to the directions so our activity can be a success. I gave each graduate a token before you walk down the aisle. Please retrieve your token, but do not turn it on. So you don't be asking Mrs. Orton to turn off the gym lights. Please refrain from turning on your cell phone lights or any lights you have in your possession. Is everyone ready? You guys ready? Mrs. Orton, please turn on the lights. Just like Paul, you have been plunged into darkness. Just like your life, someday you will find yourself a friend, a family member in darkness. How will you become a light that drives away the darkness and gives hope? Seniors, I'm going to read your name, and when I do, please stand and turn on your light as I share with you words of encouragement and advice on how to be a light in this world. Jacoby Miller. Carissa Hamlin. Jenna Strange. Taylor Goodman. Oh, Miller. See how our eyes turn towards the light? Even a small light has power. John 1:5 says, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." Will these seniors please stand? Alex Lawson, Christopher Bowman, Jeremy Yoakum, Amber McCauley, Ian Kincaid, Kate Lee Hall, and Ashley Jones. According to 1 Thessalonians 5:5, you are children of light and children of the day. We do not belong in the night or in the darkness. Our next group, Tabitha Bryant, Morgan Miller, Angel Harrison, Sky Yu, Noah Talton, Lane Couch, Amber Haynes. Luke 34:35 states, "Your eyes, the lamp of your body. When your eyes are healthy, your whole body is also also full of light. But when they are unhealthy, your body is also full of darkness. See to it then that the light within you is not darkness. Sheldon Boatman, please stand. With Vera Miller, Lindsay Hubble, Kyle Strange, Jessica Ludic, Austin Wong, and Lee Burgess. Isaiah 61 says, arise and shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. These seniors need to stand and shine your light. Ace Clucky, Katie Wiles, Grace McCullough, Zoe Goodhouse, Michelle Aronson, Josh Hamlin, Isaiah Preeby. 1 John 2:8, I am writing you a new command. Its truth is in him and in you, because the darkness is passing and the true light is already shining. Our next group, H. Kermsey, Adeline Hunsiker, Tanner Marble, Caitlin Ewald, Cheyenne Schrag, Tanner Ellison, Sarah Snelling. 1 John 1:5, this is the message we heard from Jesus, and now declare to you, God is light, and there is no darkness in him at all. Derek Haley, we stand with Jacob Bryant, Emma Heisel, Jacob Sanders, Mercedes Lick, and Zeke Schieferdegger. 1 John 1:7, but if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us from all sin. And our final group, Hunter Plucky, Stephen Powers, Madison McCabe, Sam Skinner, and in honor of our early graduates, Trent Kokenauer, Bradley Hamlin. In John 8:12, Jesus says, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Look at our graduates. As you can see, light is a marvelous thing. It physically dispels the darkness while providing hope and security. God is the creator of physical light as well as the giver of spiritual light by which we can see the truth. Light exposes that which is hidden in darkness. It shows things as they really are. To walk in the light and shine your light means to know God, understand the truth, and live in righteousness. God is light, and it is his plan that believers shine forth his light, becoming more like Christ every day. The light of the world desires to banish the darkness, bestow God's goodness everywhere. And graduates, you may sit down and keep your lights on, please. Now I invite everyone to turn on the lights of their cell phones as I share one final message. Graduates, your family, friends, and community members are gathered around you today, shining their lights to celebrate what you have done and what you are to become. Remember, Matthew 5:14-16 said, you are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor does anyone light a lamp and put it under a bowl, but on the lampstand it gives light to all who are in the house. Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Once again, thank you for letting me share your special day. May God bless you and keep you. Fight the shadows and let your light shine for all to see.
Thank our wonderful faculty and staff for working to help better our education. we appreciate all of you, whether you're teaching us calculus, cooking food for our lunch, or keeping things safe and clean around the school. Thank you to our friends and family for supporting us in everything, whether big or small. We wouldn't have made it here today if it weren't for the people at home. It honestly doesn't feel quite real yet, although actually now that I'm standing here, it really does. We've been waiting for this day for a long time. I was one of those kids that was ready to graduate from the moment I set foot in this building. These past 4 years have taken us down more paths than we'd ever imagined. We faced a lot of things that at the end of the day, many of us weren't prepared for. This is something that, if all the lengthy stories from our parents and grandparents are true, we'll be facing the rest of our lives. Although I was always the first one to harp on high school, it has taught me a lot about myself. High school brings out the best and the worst in you, but this is a journey I know I did not face alone. I look at us graduates now, and I can still remember us as when I first met you all in the seventh grade. I remember how Madison McCabe and Carissa Hamlin were basketball stars even then. I remember how Grace McCauley introduced me to everyone in the grade. And I especially remember how Sam Skinner moonwalked by me at my first school dance, winked, and shot some finger guns my way. To all who didn't know me at the time, lucky you, but I'll try to paint a picture. I wore a lot of Batman t-shirts, as seen in the video. I corrected a lot of grammar, and I carried around Mrs. English's copy of the complete works of William Shakespeare between classes. I was the worst. I was about as pretentious as they come, and I'm sure my classmates can attest to this, but I think I had a redeeming quality. I, like a lot of other 12-year-olds, had a pretty big dream. I wanted to be an actress. But as high school rolled around, I quickly found myself having to face the pressure of an impending career. By the end of freshman year, I looked at the jobs that could support my acting. By sophomore year, I'd pretty much given up on it. And by junior year, I'd pretty much decided I'd major in political science. Growing up does that to people. It's a mixture of fear of what other people will think and a fear of the unknown that makes us doubt ourselves. But by this spring, I realized I'd never be happy if I weren't pursuing theater. I'll be attending Lindenwood University this fall and majoring in acting. So for all you parents out there still worried about what your kids are doing after high school, it could be worse. What I'm trying to say is that as we leave this stage of our lives and prepare for the next one, I hope each and every one of you has the courage and faith to do what you love and to do it unapologetically. You have the potential to be what you want to be and to go where you want to go. We've been blessed to be in a community that seems to permanently be on a first name basis. And we've been given teachers that have taught us all that we can be. I hope that all of you find the intelligence and selflessness in Mr. Knapp, the depth and understanding of Mr. Short, and the passion for your career of Mr. Kerr. You have friends and family that will love you unconditionally, whether you always believe they will or not, and you'll always have a place to call home. I pray that all of you go from this gymnasium prepared to meet whatever comes next, with the grace of adults and the fearlessness of your seventh grade selves. The ones that knew no limits, the ones that weren't afraid of tomorrow, because tomorrow is always a given. It has been an honor graduating with you here today. Congratulations, class of 2017. We did it.
Elizabeth Aronson. Jacob William Bryant. Danielle Bryant. Emma Jean Heisel. Lindsay Ann Hubble. Cage Daniel Kernsey. Morgan Nicole Miller. Stephen Douglas Ray Powers. Jacob Alvin Ray Sanders. Ezekiel Gene Schieferdecker. Samuel Adrian Skinner. Sarah Elizabeth Snell. Marcus Strange. Rebecca Catherine Wiles. Jeremy Brendan Yoko. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2017.